again. Come on. Today, well, it's actually like very late at night. What are you doing?
Why isn't this working?
Oh, I think I dropped it in.
Oh my god!
Oh. Trying to be spooky for Halloween.
Ew, lift the camera up. Oh. Nothing's working. Okay, I gotta go.
Today, I thought that it would be best to take you along a journey of gathering food and having a mukbang with the two of us. Because I feel like it's been a while since we caught you up on just life in general.
It's been a while since I've left the house. And I'm nervous about it. I'm wearing my robe, blocking the haters. And by haters, I mean my rolls. I'm taking a break.
And by break, he means eating with me on my channel.
Yeah. Okay. Sorry. This is the first time I've seen myself in 3 months because I don't look in mirrors. Well, it's not great.
I have like a huge scar because you picked my acne and then I'm like breaking out on my forehead.
God, Ariana and Pete are... Well, they split up. They couldn't compete. They couldn't compete.
Okay, so I was thinking a combination of like Burger King since they have all this crazy food right now.
Wait, is this like a Halloween treat? Is this, what kind of video is this? What are we doing?
Halloween was yesterday, but I think, honestly, a lot of people are concerned about the state of our lives.
Are they?
I mean, in my Twitter feed, yes. So like 10
people.
Wait,
what does that mean? What do you mean?
Well, they want to know about the rats. They want to know about you and your life. They want to know about our pets. If we're getting a farm.
I mean, I can sum it up real quick.
Well, no, don't do that.
The rats are still there. I look like this and that's it.
All right, let's go get some food. Now I do want to give a huge shout out to today's sponsor, which just so happens to be SeatGeek. If you haven't heard of SeatGeek before, they are a ticketing company that gathers tickets from all over the web and puts them into one place, making buying tickets very simple. What I love about SeatGeek is that they have an awesome rating system. They rate tickets from 1 to 10 to let you know if you're getting a good deal. And the cool thing about it is that when you're purchasing a ticket, you can actually see the view of the stage from your seat, so you know exactly what you're getting into before you buy the ticket. And today, SeatGeek is giving all of you guys $20 off of your first purchase to any event when you use code Ryland. Again, that is code Ryland for $20 off of any tickets. You can click the link down in my description section below to download the app. I was just telling Shane that I legitimately have not had, oh my gosh, I'm gonna have to figure out what to do with my forehead. But I haven't had Burger King in probably 3 to 4 years. And I was telling Shane that my favorite thing used to be their like original chicken sandwich. Do you remember that?
Oh, the long one.
Yeah.
See, I liked it because the immense amount of mayonnaise.
Yeah, and it has like a little spice to it if I'm remembering correctly.
Yes, if I'm remembering correctly to 1 week ago, to last night, then I remember.
No, I was actually looking up just now like the 50 best fast food items. Guess what number one is?
Oh, is that my phone?
This is according to The Ringer. I'm not sure what that is. But number one is Chick-fil-A's waffle fries. And then it is my favorite, Double Double from In-N-Out, which,
This, who made this? Chick-fil-A can suck a dick, which they would hate, by the way. Chick-fil-A's so overrated, so not good. Come for me, Chickies. Come for me, little fillets.
I got a haircut today. Hi. All right.
Content.
What are you doing?
Hollywood fix.
Oh yeah, Shane Dawson? What are you doing tonight?
Oh well, I am going into Rite Aid to get Halloween candy because I'm too old to trick or treat, and I have emotional eating issues.
What is this fashion, this robe?
Oh, this is a robe, and I love it. This is a shirt that was on my Amazon store, and then I took it off because I found out the artist stole it from somebody. Look at her, she's like, do you need help?
Yes, the answer is yes. Oh my gosh, wait, I love Reese's so much.
I wanna go where the candy is. Oh my god, wait, why do you look like all of them?
Okay, I'm gonna take that as a compliment, even if you didn't mean it that way. I mean, we need to find the most fun thing. I feel like there's like assortments of candy that are fun. Do you like candy corn?
Oh, my favorite are the little pumpkins.
You mean the big pumpkins?
Yeah.
Should we get one of each?
No, because I ate too many of them one year and then I threw up.
I haven't had candy corn in years either, so I'm just gonna get a small little bag.
Oh
my God. Wait,
what? I really
missed
myself.
That's
crazy.
Oh my God. Wait, we need that. Yeah, okay,
That's me.
That's our shopping cart.
Okay.
Wait. Oh, why do I feel like this one's me with their front two teeth?
Wait, it is with a little hair on top.
Wait, oh my gosh. Oh, I'm offended. Wait, Three Musketeers. I feel like I low-key like that.
My grandma used to give me those before she wiped my butt.
Oh, dark.
Candy sticks are kind of flat.
Hey.
There's nothing like crazy. Like, I thought there was gonna be like pumpkin.
Whoa, Twix.
Beer.
No, I don't think there's like pumpkin flavored candy. This is pumpkin flavored, I think.
Oh, it's just orange colored. This candy.
Whoa, okay. Look at this assortment.
I'm looking.
Pretty good.
I approve.
Wait, so you want it?
No.
Why are all the skeletons ready for like a dick in the ass? Look at the way that his legs are positioned.
Shane.
What? Or is that too far?
You're too far.
Are you an LGBT plus channel? That's culturally insensitive. Or am I just being triggered? Sorry, just an afro on a white woman. Like they didn't even. I gotta go. Oh my God, wait, that's me.
I'd like to think that one's me.
Wait, she's removing her own head. I might need that. So we were checking out and we were, you know, giving them our stuff, which is coffee, candy, and two boxes of lube. and it was a fan. Just checking us out. She was really sweet. Hi, Breeze. What's her name? So Breeze, thank you for asking us if we wanted a discount on our lubricant. Better than VidCon.
Okay, we also stopped at Starbucks because Shane really wanted to try this witch's brew.
He hates vlogging in public.
Can you go?
Whoa,
Cute. It actually looks like really good. Those are supposed to be, what did you say, witches something?
Bat balls or something?
Oh, bat warts.
Right.
But they're chia seeds.
Well, I have back warts, so it makes sense.
Ew.
Oh.
Wait, you hate it? It's that bad? Let me try it. Hold on.
It tastes like cum.
Ew. Shane.
It has a consistency of cum.
Oh.
Wait, yeah.
Well, it's because we drank straight chia seeds. So you got it.
People drink that? I only drink that if I'm in love.
Oh.
Without the ejaculate?
Yeah, you gotta get the purple. You were just drinking straight chia seeds, which is like a specific type of something. Oh wait, you hate it that much?
I gotta.
I mean, it does taste like Fruity Pebbles.
No, the taste is good, but like the.
Well, yeah. I mean, if you've ever had chia seeds.
Why would anybody drink that? Oh no, Starbucks. What happened?
Is it bad that I kind of like it?
Once again, part of the LGBT. I mean,
we've made. I'm so excited. What are you gonna get?
Oh man, I don't know. I'm trying to figure out why they have tacos. I have a lot of questions. I actually have not been to Burger King in maybe 10 years.
Oh man. Wait, okay. Oh, it's all happening.
Wait, they're gonna. Oh, wait, I'm getting nervous. Okay. I'm feeling pressure.
I hate this part.
Hi, open the Burger King.
Hi, how's it going? Could I get
a
fish diet Coke? Yeah, do you guys still have the green burger?
Yes, we do.
Could I get that?
Oh, and the black drink? There's like a black drink.
And then do you have a black drink still?
Are you pregnant? What's happening?
What do you mean?
That was a lot.
Well, yeah, I just wanted to try a little bit of everything. It's my first, I've done a mukbang before, but never like driving through and doing fast food.
Wow.
I like stopped really eating fast food, to be honest, and it's not—
I'm bored! Whoa, fuck.
Oh my gosh, no wonder people eat at Burger King.
My mom,
oh, wait.
Everything I do is in my time and— Oh, you caught me.
Oh my gosh, wait. I'm starving. Can we do, like, before we get home, a pre-like appetizer, like some cheesy tots or something?
Wait, what?
Yeah, there's cheesy tots in there.
I need a light.
Whoa, oh my god, is that a ghost?
Do you— Orbs!
Wait, no, that really is weird. Or is it there just something in my
light?
Oh.
Oh my gosh, show them before you eat. They look so good.
There we go, we've made progress. Whoa.
Yes, we're mukbanging. People are looking.
Oh my god, can you hold this?
Ah! Yum!
Okay, it's warm and gooey.
Okay, that's me, but I feel like... I think I only like Mexican fast food. Like, I only like Taco Bell.
I mean...
I don't care about, like, cheesy teasies and, like, burgers and stuff. I just don't... It's, like, not my thing.
That's weird. I mean...
We're gonna crash.
I'm sorry. I love Wendy's. I love In-N-Out.
Wait, literally getting on a freeway. Okay, hold on. We're mukbanging. We're on the freeway. You're cheesy totting. I'm scared.
All right, I'll see you at home. What are you eating?
Mm-hmm.
Shane, you have to eat Burger King with all of us. Our cheesy tots.
Wait, why does the receipt say one nightmare? Did you see that?
Oh, that must be what the green thing is, the green burger. Ah! The chicken sandwich. Oh, I'm so excited about this. The fries.
Ooh, oh, she's big. God. Wait, I want one. Okay, yeah. No, you have her.
Thanks,
babe. Wait, we could share it. Thank you.
Okay, don't give me a kiss or anything, just literally. Oh my god, this must be the green one.
Ooh, I'm excited.
What are these? Oh my god, I forgot we got chicken nuggets. Whoa, I didn't get enough sauces, I only got ranch.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine.
Another okay. My review of their fries, they're immediately too salty for me.
That's my review of my Twitter feed, which is why I stopped looking at it.
Wow, this is a really crooked angle. Hold please while I...
Ow!
What?
Wait.
No, what?
Someone just happened.
What?
Leave the camera on.
I wasn't...
You might have to go to the emergency room.
Stop it, not before we eat. Wait, did you like break a tooth?
I don't know.
What happened? Let me see, are you being dramatic?
Okay, I think it's okay.
What happened?
I thought I broke the wire behind my tooth. Sorry, we're fine.
Okay, I'm not like a mukbanger, but I think you're like supposed to get a thumbnail before you start really eating, right?
Are you gonna call this video a mukbang?
I mean, yeah.
There's so many other better options.
Like what?
Oh man, like a fan sold me sex toys.
But demonetized.
I
guess the fries are pretty good.
Shane's, we had a nightmare?
About what?
We'll think about it. What's going on?
Okay, I gotta make a thumbnail. The green burger. Oh, ew!
That?
Ew, oh my god, there's bacon.
That looks like when I used to like make food on my channel. I'd be like, it's a green burger, but I just like painted it with green markers.
Oh my god.
That's, I should be Burger King.
Oh wait, is there chicken and beef?
That's why it's called the nightmare.
Whoa.
It's a vegan's nightmare. Aren't you vegan?
I was like going, and I heard that it's really like not appropriate to say I'm 80% vegan, but I was saying that I was 80% vegetarian, but I've kind of fallen off. And it was more for like, I don't know, I got really into like wanting a farm, which I still want a farm, but the problem is, can you have a farm and still eat farm animals?
There's a lot of things that just happened.
I just try not to eat bacon because I want a pig. Should I make this thumbnail, yeah.
Is that what's actually happening?
I mean, as an option. I don't know if it's going to be it. You don't want the sandwich?
Oh, like in my face?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, wait. Oh, I want a mayonnaise-y bite. All my childhood memories rushing back.
Wait, you already had a bite of it?
No.
Shane, that was for the thumbnail!
Does it taste like a nightmare?
Honestly, yes. Like, the beef-chicken combo is not- they've really figured out their buns, though.
Me.
They're like perfectly moist, the buns. Isn't the combination of meat and, like, beef and chicken not worth it?
There's something really weird and something I don't like in here. What was the point of this lip balm? Is there like a point?
I don't know, I just feel like we're at a pivotal point in both of our lives. And I felt like it was time for like an update. I mean, are you kidding me? We really are, like, I saw a lot of people concerned about the rats in our house, so I think that's like a good launching point.
I don't know how to do this.
Why? What do you mean?
I'm not good at mukbangs.
I mean, neither am I. Didn't you do one with Trish? Like, haven't you done multiple with Trish?
Well, I feel weird because I don't like eating in front of people because I get triggered.
About what?
Everything. I feel like people are judging me, or people are being like, why is he eating? He shouldn't be eating. Or people are going to be like, he's not eating enough. Like, oh my God, there's a problem. So then I don't eat on camera because I feel weird about it.
Well, you have to eat.
Those are my favorite words. Okay, I'm gonna figure this out. Okay, I'll eat, but also we'll do topics. Is that how this works?
Yeah.
Oh, that was mayonnaise-y.
Whoa. It's like I remembered it.
I need that one, that bite right there.
Okay.
Please. No, fuck off. That one.
Mine! My biggest pet peeve is I'll eat food in the fridge that I don't like necessarily finish, or I'm gonna like save for later. And every time I go back to it, Shane's taken like the biggest bite out of the middle, which makes the rest of whatever I'm eating fall apart. And there's just nothing makes me more mad. And he like was like, why don't you think that's like something that's cute about me? Like, it's cute. And I'm like, because I love food. And I'm sure like everyone, if you have food that you know is in the fridge that you want to eat, you wait till you're hungry and you go find that food that's in the fridge. And when it's not there, it's like the worst.
Survival of the fittest, baby. When you're living with me, if you don't eat your food right away, say goodbye.
Well, that's also why I don't, you know, ever since I've lived with you, I haven't grocery shopped. You like don't allow it.
Yeah, I can't have food around, I'll eat it.
Well, I don't even think that's it. I guess it is. But this is really good. The original chicken sandwich is where it's at.
Okay, what are we talking about?
Cheeto. This isn't your,
he's gonna do it.
Wait, no.
Cheeto?
If he steals a whole chicken nugget, he knows that I'm so close to him, I don't think he will.
He's about to. Oh, here it goes.
Stop it.
Here it goes. Oh, now he's pretending like he's like, oh no, I was just hanging out on the table. Like, no, I was like literally like chilling, like whatever. Oh, looking around, I'm like, yeah, no, I'm just looking around. And then here we go.
Cause one time he took, oh. I think he's scared of all the paper. Oh,
he's gonna run away.
You're that comfortable eating it in front of me, Cheeto? Are you kidding me? If this camera wasn't on, I would be screaming at him like I normally do, and I think that's why.
It's so cute. Look
Stop!
At him. Wait, the nugget was stuck on his nail.
Oh my God. Wait, where did he go?
Where's he taking it?
Where's he gone?
Oh my God. Me, I'm eating in private. Cheeto. Not wanting to eat on camera. You should get a close-up shot of that green burger.
Oh, yeah. Oh, it. The bacon.
That's the worst thing ever. I know what I want to do.
What?
We talked about doing this earlier.
What?
Wait, I want to have a serious talk.
About what?
It's been a month since I've had a really serious talk on a couch and I'm ready. I want to ask you about your past.
What do you mean?
Well, what do you think of me?
I don't know. I mean, there's a lot of a past that I'm not exactly proud of.
What? Okay. Let's start with that. What do you mean? What are you talking about?
I mean, we can start with the Musical.ly that you found of me and screamed the other day about.
So here's my confusion with Rylan Adams. So when I met him and I was looking through his Tinder, there was a shirtless picture. I didn't see it right away, so I still went on the date. If I would have seen that first, probably wouldn't have.
I don't believe you. You low-key, like, it was just something that, I don't know, you saw it.
I did see it, I'm lying, you caught me. But it is something that, like, if I didn't know who you were, I would have said no to the date, or I wouldn't have went. Because a shirtless picture to me is like I'm never gonna fuck with that person because, like, they're way too confident and, like, I can't.
I don't think that's necessarily fair to put on me, though. Like, yes, I do think when I was posting shirtless, like, photos on Instagram, I was going through, like, I don't know, that's like a weird mindset to be in, like posting scandalous, but and if you do that, I mean, I'm
well,
not
that's my question though. It's like, okay, so this Musical.ly came up in Twitter the other day, and it was of him right when we first met, and it was what's a word?
Awful, cringy, crazy, obnoxious, scary and sad for me to watch right now.
Yeah, all the above. Baby, I- I thought it was amazing. I thought it was incredible. I actually thought you were pretty good. Like, baby Ariel, she's not shook. She, like, moved a little bit, but, like, she's fine.
Well, I had watched baby Ariel's, like, tutorial on YouTube. On how to make a musically, like you lift the camera and point up and then go down and over and over and whoop. I could do that. Why I chose to be shirtless in this musically, I don't know.
But that's my question is like, so then I started really going back through your feed and you were getting mad at me because you're like, don't look. Oh my God, I hate those pictures. I'm so embarrassed.
But I think it's the same thing as when I first started dating you, we would scroll through your YouTube channel and you'd be like, oh no, you can't click that video. And I'd be like jumping over the couch trying to click on it and you'd be chasing me like, don't watch that video. And I think it's similar. Hey, Cheeto's back. I think you did.
No.
No, there were multiple times where you were like, I don't want you to see that video. And I don't think...
No, I didn't want you to see my body. The videos were fine. So when we were looking at them today, and I hope you put them on the screen right now, there were some that I was just like, I want to know the backstory. I'm like, okay, why are you next to the, you know, washing machine? Why are you shirtless? Why?
Okay.
Who took it?
I will say, in the height of me being a model on Instagram, making no money... I think here was my thought process. I was in LA, surrounded by a lot of, I can't even fathom, because right now.
I feel like I'm interviewing Jake again.
Posting, like posing for a shirtless photo that I'm taking to post on Instagram sounds like my nightmare and like right now's state of mind. So I don't really know why, but these specific laundry ones were like the craziest it got.
Yeah, why did you do that? Like, what made you say like, oh, time to do this?
I guess like validation or attention or something. At that time I was like waiting tables. I felt like shit about myself. I think that was a like way for me to, I don't know. I honestly don't know.
So then after you took them, was your roommate who took it like, pay me, or like, why, what is this? Here's the thing, it's not the shirtless part of it, right? Because I don't want people to be like, Shane, I like to be shirtless, I'm offended. Listen, can't relate, but also, it's not about that, because that's fine. It's the
There's still a way to...
the modeling thing.
Yeah.
Because it's like, I was like, oh, did he want to be a model? And if so...
And that answer is no. I think I wanted, Today, sometimes I like post photos on Instagram where I happen to be shirtless, but it's not like I'm like oiling up, taking my shirt off, grabbing a ring light, and
you
being like,
"Shit, up?
No, that was an exaggeration."
You oiled up for the musically?
No, I did not oil.
Baby Ariel thinks that's too far. Should we talk about the future?
Yeah.
So we might get a llama.
Okay. The llama's pushing it. For sure, goats.
Your Instagram poll said we should.
Yeah.
So there's that. Instagram controls my farm!
Oh my God! That's everything. I do think we're gonna have a farm soon.
Yeah, I want a farm. I want a life.
I mean, of course I would hope you would want a life.
Well, no, but I feel like lately, the last year has been really like all work, crazy, like not taking a break, not whatever.
Yeah.
You know, and that's been kind of hard.
Yeah, it's been a learning curve. I mean, just learning how to like work and maintain everything, especially with you, because you're like so in it, which is great. I mean, it really is, because it's changed everything and you love what you're making, which is everything that anybody could ever want.
Yeah. You know what's interesting? We've never really talked about our issues. Which is good, but like on YouTube, because I feel like...
I thought you meant like in real life. I was like, I would hope so. We've like started like quite the long haul with each other to not have talked about any issue.
I have a few more. No, we don't really do that, but I guess that's a good thing. So I guess people don't know, because it has been a rough like 6 months, because I've been working a lot and then I haven't like been showering and I've been like staying up all night.
Wearing the same shirt for the entire month that you wore. I mean, it's because you, and our schedules are 100% off because you'll start editing at 2 p.m. and then you're so deep in it that you don't go to bed until 7 a.m. And then it's been like a patch of like learning how to work and navigate a relationship. But luckily, I think we love each other enough to want to fight that fight, you know?
Yeah, I mean, I think I feel like We're gonna have a really good life. I'm excited.
Well, I would hope so.
I feel like we shouldn't. Well, there's things that are hopefully are happening soon that we're not talking about. But I guess we'll talk about it later. I don't know.
I think it's safe to say. I don't have to say like an official announcement or anything, but.
Okay, so he's pregnant.
Oh,
and we're not deciding it. We're letting them do it. No, we're moving.
Yeah,
we're actually moving,
which
into
is
a different house.
Crazy.
And I don't feel nervous at all. I think it's weird. It's like I had an epiphany. I was thinking about it because we were mukbanging, and you can do a flashback. But I had like a minor breakdown because I felt weird. I was like, I'm not good at mukbanging. I feel weird. I'm sorry.
Why?
I don't know. I feel like I'm coming across really bad on this. I'm just like, I don't know. I really guess I don't like mukbanging. I feel weird.
But I think the reason is because I feel like on your channel, sometimes I have to play like a character or something.
Right.
Because you were kind of playing a character.
Well, and I've been going back and forth with that myself, like with my last two videos. Because honestly, I mean, I did learn a lot of how to be on the internet from you. And then when you got so invested in your work, I really had to be like, okay, I have to like come up with a creative concept and like hold the video by myself. Cause like you are like somebody I play off of. Well, and then my sister came into my life as well, but she travels a lot. So more recently I've been like teetering on the line. Cause like I used to honestly just think like me talking to the camera was not enough to be entertainment.
Yeah. I mean, I feel like just being ourselves. I think you have been yourself. More recently,
yeah.
Me just being myself a little bit more on your channel will be fun because there is a lot that's gonna happen. We're moving, there's a lot of things that I'm not probably gonna show on my channel because I don't really like vlog.
Yeah.
But on your channel, I think that'll be fun and then we can look back at it when we're old.
But I do think I'll be documenting like a lot of the aspect of like the move in general and just like redecorating and stuff because that's gonna be a big process. How did you decorate your last house by yourself?
All by myself. Listen, Mr. Kate is me.
It's been weird, like, sleeping on an air mattress.
It's been weird doing things on an air mattress.
Stop it, Shane.
Because I'm self-conscious, and then when the air mattress starts to pop...
Oh my god. Well, the first air mattress, we are on our second air mattress, but I don't think the first one was like...
That triggered
popped by us. And we also got candy from... Oh my god, I haven't had candy corn in like so many years. And then Reese's, is that all we got, really?
I know, that's depressing. Nobody invited us to a Halloween party. By the way, tonight is the night that everybody goes to Halloween parties. We never get invited to anything.
But here, listen up. I was walking the dogs with Shane and he was like, wait, we didn't get invited to any Halloween parties. And I was like, Shane, okay. The problem is, if anyone invited us to a Halloween party, we wouldn't have gone.
Of course not. But
it's nice to be invited.
But I want to see the text and then I want to respond with like a really sweet lie. And then I want to know like, oh, people care.
And then we're going to sit on this couch and watch YouTube anyway. Which has also been very nice. You really haven't since you, I mean, obviously you work nonstop, but you have been like taking a legit second for yourself, which is great.
I'm getting fat.
He came to bed at 4 a.m. last night and was like, I gotta stop eating. And I was like, Shane, you look so good. I think you look good. I do.
I'm gonna get a lie detector test.
Do you think we're gonna have
kids?
Yeah.
Two, but I think we'll be good dads.
Well, I'm gonna be the dad that's like a lot. I'm gonna be the dad that needs to, you need to have like one of the cussing jars. Something worse than that. Like a jar for every time I like talk about murder or talk about like my ass or something.
Oh, like you're gonna have a
trigger jar.
Right. But you're also, I'm gonna be the bad cop and I already know it. And like sometimes they're gonna come home from school and there's gonna be like a bouncy castle and like Shane's the fun dad and I'm the one that's like, you have to stop jumping to do your homework and like freaking out about dinner. And
yeah, but that's fine because I'm gonna die first. So when I die in like 10 years, then they're gonna have had fun. And then mama takes over and like actually races. And then like, but then dad's like that memory, like, oh, remember how fun, the bouncy castle?
I am not raising kids alone. You gotta like sign a contract that you're staying alive for like at least 50 years. Or I guess 20, because the kids are gonna be like, by the time they're 18, it's like decently okay for me to be like raising. But then what about me? Oh no. I envisioned us on rocking chairs at like 75. I'm gonna get a rocking chair at this new house. Two of them. One for me, one for you. Just look at the wilderness. Alright, I think that's all I have for today. Thank you for eating with me. Thank you, animals, for staring at us the entire video. And I guess I'll see you guys next week. Cheetah's going in for the burger. We gotta go.